Hi there, and welcome back to the Forever Notes Setup video series. In this video, you'll learn how to use tags effectively to organize your notes and make your digital life a whole lot easier. Tags make your notes dynamic, letting them exist in multiple places at once, giving them meaning, context, or even a status. Tags are a core part of the Forever Notes framework because they help you create connections between notes, making it easier to find and use your information without getting bogged down by rigid structures. Instead of losing notes deep in endless folders, tags give you a smarter, faster way to find what you need. Let's jump in and see how tags work in Forever Notes. Hi, I'm Matthias, and I created Forever Notes to help turn digital chaos into clarity using Apple Notes. I know what it's like to feel overwhelmed with endless notes and not enough organization, and this system was my way of solving that problem. If you're just starting with Forever Notes, definitely check out my introduction video. It'll give you a full overview, and if you haven't set up your heavy asterisk or home note yet, make sure you watch those setup videos too. Those are the first two building blocks of the Forever Notes framework. As always, I'll be demonstrating the setup on iOS, but these steps apply across all Apple devices, so whether you're on an iPhone, iPad, or Mac, you'll be able to follow along. All right, today we're talking about tags. They're super simple but incredibly powerful. They help you categorize your notes in a way that makes everything easy to find, without the limitations of a traditional folder system. For example, if you have a work project note that also relates to personal growth, you can add both hashtag work and hashtag personal, making it accessible through multiple contexts. This flexibility means no more digging through countless folders. Just search by tags and get what you need instantly. In Forever Notes, all notes are stored in the default notes folder. This might feel unconventional at first, since we're used to organizing files into many layers of folders. However, tags replace the need for folder hierarchies by making it easier to categorize and access notes without getting lost in complex structures. Searching for a note in a folder structure can be frustrating. You have to remember exactly where you put it, and folders only allow a note in one spot. This can lead to decision fatigue and wasted time. Tags, on the other hand, work like our brains do, using multiple associations. A single note can have several tags, which means you can find it through different pathways depending on what makes sense at that moment. It's faster, more intuitive, and takes the stress out of organizing. In Forever Notes, we use five types of tags. Object tags tell you what the note is, like hashtag document, hashtag recipe, or hashtag booknote. Object tags make it easier to quickly identify the purpose of a note, allowing you to filter and gather similar types of information instantly. If you're familiar with the Para method by Tiago Forte, you'll recognize the concept of areas. Just like in Para, area tags and Forever Notes help categorize notes into major life domains like health, finance, family, or work. These areas represent the ongoing aspects of your life that rarely change. They are the consistent themes and responsibilities you deal with daily, whether it's managing your health routines, tracking finances, or organizing work projects. Area tags make it simple to find everything related to a specific part of your life instantly. Detail tags add more specific information about a note, allowing you to add extra layers of detail that can make searching even more effective. For example, if you have a recipe, you can use tags like hashtag cold or hashtag hot to indicate temperature, or hashtag Italian and hashtag Asian to indicate cuisine type. Detail tags help you to get really granular. So when you need to find something precise, like a hot Italian dish, you can do so instantly. Status tags are for keeping track of the status of your notes, whether something is hashtag in progress or hashtag done, or even hashtag to do. Status tags are all about action. They help you understand where certain notes are in your workflow, making sure nothing falls through the cracks. The Forever Notes tag is a special tag that is used to organize system level notes. For example, every Forever Notes system note like home, hubs, or journal notes get the tag hashtag Forever Notes. This makes it easy to find all the core elements of the framework whenever you need them. The philosophy in Forever Notes is that every note should have at least one tag. This keeps your notes interconnected and ensures that no information gets lost. You also have the option to create an inbox smart folder that automatically shows all notes without any tags yet, making it easy to keep track of unorganized content. When I create a new note, I like to ask myself a few simple questions to guide the tagging process. Let's walk through an example together. Say you just started reading a new book and want to create a note about it. So I would ask myself, what type of note is this? This is a book note, so I add an object tag like #booknote. Which part of my life does this relate to? This book is for self-improvement, so I include an area tag like #personal. What details can help me find this note later? Maybe this book is about productivity, so I add a detail tag like #productivity. What's the current state of this note? You're still working on this note, so add a status tag like #inprogress. Is this a core part of my system? Since this isn't a system of a note, it doesn't need the #forevernotes tag. But if it were, you'd tag it accordingly. Now that we've walked through how to create and categorize notes with tags, let's look at some examples to get you started. Here's some tags that will give you an idea of how to organize your notes effectively and make searching a breeze. When building your tagging system, think about your notes you make most often. The goal here is to keep your tags clear and descriptive. Remember, only use what makes sense for you. Less is more when it comes to tagging your notes. Over-tagging can make things messy and harder to manage, which is why it's important to be intentional with the tags you choose. For example, tagging a book note with #booknote, #reading, #personal, and #inspiration may seem thorough, but it could end up cluttering your system. Instead, a well-balanced approach might be to use just #booknote and #personal to keep it focused and easily searchable. The right balance makes searching simple, keeps your note system efficient, makes your workflow feel seamless, and reduces mental clutter. Let's walk through how to actually add tags in your notes. Open the Notes app and create a new note or open an existing one. Just type a #symbol followed by the tag name, like #project. If it's a new tag, it will turn yellow after you type a space, indicating it has been created. If the tag already exists, suggestions will appear above your keyboard to quickly select from your existing tags. Once tags are added, you can use the search bar in the Notes app to find notes by typing the relevant tag. You can even use multiple tags at once, like #work and #inprogress, to narrow down your results and filter notes more precisely. You also find all the tags in the tag sections under your folders. You can also use smart folders to automatically group notes based on specific tags into collections. More about that in the next video. Be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for when it comes out. So what makes tags so powerful? It's all about making information easy to retrieve. With effective tagging, you don't waste time hunting around for that one note. You just search and go. Everything becomes a simple search away, so you can spend more time doing and less time searching. Imagine you're planning a dinner party and you need a vegetarian main course. Just search for #recipe, #vegetarian, #hot, and voila, everything you need is right there. This works for everything from tracking work projects to organizing personal memories. If you enjoyed this and found it helpful, stick around. In the next video, I'll show you how to set up collections, another framework component that is going to help you level up your digital notes organization. And of course, make sure to hit subscribe and sign up for my newsletter so you don't miss any future tips and tricks on mastering ForeverNotes. You can also check out my website, myforevernotes.com, for detailed documentation on the framework. Thanks for watching and happy note-taking, everyone.